UTI, Universal Technical mm-hmm. Institute. Some guys like it, some guys hate it. It's right. It's either yes or no.
Right.
There's not a lot of gray area. When you're looking for somebody, do you look for experience over education? Do you look for education over experience? What are your thoughts on that?
It's right now in the industry, it's very difficult to find people that have either or. I've hired guys from UTI, and what I find is they know a lot about the book, they have very little experience, and some of them don't even know how to use the tools. You know, hey, look, I graduated from UTI. For me, that has never worked out. Not one time. I think I've done it three times. Every time, maybe it went 6 months because I tried to let the guy go, you know, try to keep him going, and then in the end, I'm like, you can't work here. it couldn't work out for me. We were desperate for people, so we're looking, and so, you know, you start looking, and there's these job hunters or whatever, those people that do whatever they do. And so we found UTI. So we asked them, hey, what are some of your best guys that are graduating that might be, you know, people we're looking for? This is what we do. And so they sent us a couple of applicants, interviewed a couple of them, like, no, a bunch of no's. And, oh, maybe this guy. He seems nice. He seems polite. He seems whatever. And so he, in turn, would come to us, and then we're like, okay, let's give this guy a shot.
Mm-hmm.
And like I said, 3 for 3 didn't work out. But I'm not saying that means all the guys at UTI. There could be some great ones coming out of there. It's just my experience with the 3 I had did not work out for me.
Yeah.
So say that kid who maybe started working on a car when he was young with his friends or something like that. That's kind of the best guy because he's into it and he wants to do it. He's interested in it.
Yeah.
So that guy can turn into somebody, But you're not really sure. You just don't know. I mean, I've hired all those guys. I've hired UTI guys. I've hired other guys. And the bottom line is you just don't really know what you're going to get. You know what I mean? Until you get it. But what I'm looking for is somebody who does have mechanical knowledge, but at the same time, you have to be into it. You have to have that curious mind. You have to want to know how something mm-hmm. works. And if you find a guy like that, then he's the best guy for me. The guy that I'm looking for is like, I don't want to train him from the beginning because it takes forever, but some of my best guys got trained from the beginning. They were into cars or trucks. They were into mechanic things. They liked to see how things worked. And so you have to have that aptitude. And if you don't, it doesn't matter all the training. And my guys could probably be better trained. Mm-hmm. But I think learning here, because we work on everything. We work on semi-trucks. We have a Honda. You saw when you came in. There's a Mercedes over there.
Yeah, Mercedes the next big.
Right. That's not our specialty. But
I'll put some pictures up of Darren's lot after this so you guys can see what he's working on.
So, you know, just those multitude of vehicles. So the guy who likes working here is the guy who likes doing something different. You know, one day you might be working on a rear end. Next day maybe an engine. Another day you're just doing light repair. You may be doing some welding, learning how to weld and all those things. I'm just looking for a guy that's like, hey, put me in, coach. I'm ready to go. I guess that's the guy I'm looking for. But pretty much the resume doesn't do much for me. I mean, I appreciate the fact that it, you know, kind of shows where he grew up or whatever. But, you know, I've looked at resumes before where it'll be like, worked here 6 months, then worked here 6 months. And so you ask the guy, so what happened? And it's never his fault. You know, it's always somebody else. But if you see even a young kid and he's worked at the same place for 2 years and he's only like 23 years old, that's probably a pretty good guy.
Yeah.
So that's kind of what I look at the resume, because I tell them all the time when I read the resume and I'm looking at them, I'm like, you know, if you're lying on this, I'm going to figure it out pretty quick. You know, I mean, I'm going to give you a job out there and then you're not going to. So, I mean, within like a couple days, I'm going to figure it out. So is this stuff true or not true? Mm-hmm. What do you really know how to do? Because you're going to get a job. And when we realize you don't know what you're doing, we're going to have a problem. So I want to see a resume, but I don't think it matters to me as much. I do want to see one. I want to have one. I want to hold one in my hand, and I do want to, you know, talk over it. But most of the time I read through it in a couple minutes, and I'm just trying to find out what kind of guy are you. It's impossible to tell who somebody is. You don't figure that out because they're on their best behavior for about 30, 60 days before you really see who they are. And so there have been guys that I've hired, and I'm thinking, this guy's never going to work out. They've been working for me 10 or 12 years. Then there's other guys, I'm like, I love this guy. And then, you know, within 3 months, I'm like, I hate this guy, you know?
This guy sucks.
Yeah, so I want to see somebody, I want to talk to somebody. But what I'm looking for, can you be kind and respectful and pleasant to me and my family? Because that's how you'll be treated. But if you can't do that, I can't teach that to you. If you don't understand respect and common courtesy, so I'm looking to work with people that know they can do that.
Okay.
You know, I've had guys that are really, really skilled, but they're not very nice people. I can't work with them.
Yeah.
Now, I'd rather work around a shop full of guys that maybe aren't the best, but they're good people, that I like them, and I'll be happy. Because I can think I can teach them. Usually you can teach them how to be a mechanic, but you can't teach somebody how to be nice. I mean, maybe you can. I haven't figured out how to do it.
There are a-holes out there.
Amen. Amen. Right?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Well, I know you got to get out of here, Darren, and yeah. I appreciate your time. I really do. And we're going to put this all together. Guys, Darren, check out his website, or just Google him, Direct Truck. And thanks for watching, guys.